I'm going to give you a brief tour of the E360 student homepage. When you first log into E360, the homepage that you see here will appear. There are many different options for you to be able to navigate through the homepage. The very first icon, the home icon, that's seen here will always take you back to the same place where you started. If you click on the courses icon, you're able to access any courses that you're enrolled in as a student, as an instructor, or as an assistant. Now, as I press the home key, it's going to take me back to that home page. The next button that I can push is the communities button. This will take me to any clubs or organizations that I might be enrolled in. If you're not enrolled in any clubs or organizations, you won't have anything to access here. The next place is the mailbox. From here, I'm able to send E360 messages. The very next tab, the grades tab, I can access grades for my E360 classes. You have control over how you see the information within this. You'll learn more in another segment. The next button, the contacts button, allows me to manage my contacts or find contacts and arrange them so that I can get in touch with people or my instructors more easily. The blog button seen here, you can create a blog for people to post in and make messages. The calendar button allows you to add information to your calendar or to manage what is on it. The logout button will log you out of E360 completely. And the help button here along the top will take you to some very useful guides and information for students. It'll also take some information into consideration, such as the user manual and video tutorials to help you out. If I click my home tab again, I'll go back to my main screen. Here, I also have buttons along the left side menu. My home page, again, will take me back to the same place as my home tab. My profile button is pretty neat. It allows me to manage information about myself so that I can share that with other people in my class. This is a great way for people to get to know you and to learn more about you. But please be aware that this information is accessible by any CVT student, faculty member, or staff member. Within this menu, I can also edit my photo and edit my biography information that is seen here. If I go back to home, again, I see some additional things along the side. I have my e-portfolio. That will allow me to post a portfolio link if I've created a portfolio to share with others. With my widgets, I can add things like a calculator or a feed to my home page if I'm trying to follow along with something. Alerts history lets me manage my alerts that I've already marked as read. We'll learn more about those in a minute. The search feature allows me to search for something specific in my course, such as lessons or discussions. And my settings button allows me to change things like the font size to make it easier to read when I'm in E360. It'll allow me to change the color contrast, manage whether I want email alerts on or off, add a signature for my email messages, and decide how I want to manage my discussion posts within E360. So lots of options there. The other information that you see when you are on the student home screen of E360 is the alert section. In this section, you'll see important information from your instructors and also from the college. Once you've read the information, you can mark as read and always go back to your alerts history to review the information later. As you go further down the screen, there's a few more important things to take note of. This personal alerts section just alerts you to how many messages you have that you need to review within your discussion boards and how many new friends have requested access to your information. The calendar this week section shows any upcoming due dates from either your personal calendar or the course calendar. And finally, the last section, the unread posts and comments, is a feed of all the discussion board posts and comments from within your courses that you have not marked as read that you since the last time that you cleared it. So this can get to be quite lengthy, but it's a nice way to get a brief overview of the discussion that's going on within your classes without having to log into each class. I hope you enjoyed your quick tour of the E360 student home screen, and in the next section, we'll be talking about how to navigate through E360 courses. Thank you.